Now we'll learn how to use CSS to really move things around. Not just put them next to each other, but actually put things on top of each other. Here we have a web page with a few headers and images and some paragraphs down here. And it's currently all laid out with the default positioning strategy which the browser uses, which we call static or normal positioning. It just means that inline elements like images are laid out from left to right, and block elements like headers and paragraphs are laid out from top to bottom. We can change that positioning strategy using the CSS position property. Let's try it on the landscape image. We'll type position, colon, and then relative for the value. The relative position strategy means position it how you normally would, but then offset it by some amount. Now, to tell the browser what amount we want to offset by, we need to use some combination of four new CSS properties: top, bottom, left, and right. Like, let's say we want to have it be 20 pixels down, say top 20 pixels, and 10 pixels over, we'll say left 10 pixels. So that's kind of neat, but not really that neat. I want to show you something way cooler: absolute positioning. We can use it to take an element completely out of the normal flow and put it anywhere on the screen. To do that, I will change relative to absolute on the landscape and keep the top left. And you can see the landscape is now hiding our images and dance party heading. And now we're going to fix that. Let's start with Winston. So add a rule for Winston and give Winston a position absolute. And then let me say top 40 pixels, so let's say top 50 pixels, and then left 50 pixels. Okay, that looks good. And Hopper is really eager to get on top as well. So let's say Hopper also needs a position absolute. And let's say top 30 pixels and left 60 pixels. Okay, so my goal is to make it look like Hopper is kind of dancing in front of Winston. But right now it doesn't look that way because Winston is being drawn on top of Hopper. To fix this, I could either change the order of the actual image tags in the HTML, but a kind of better way is to use the CSS Z-Index property. We can use that to tell the browser exactly what order to draw elements in by giving them different z-indexes. So I'll start with the landscape and give it a z-index of 1. And then Winston goes on top with 2. Hopper goes on top with 3. All right, now Hopper is dancing in front of Winston, even if he doesn't like that, but have to deal. Now we still have headings and poems that are hidden. So let's see. Let's try and get maybe I want the dance party to be on top of everything. So I'm also going to give that position absolute and Z index 4. Okay, it looks good. Maybe left 10 pixels, just move it over a bit, maybe a bit more. All right, that looks good. Now for the song lyrics, I actually just want them to display underneath everything. So for those, I'm thinking position relative, and then we could just do a top, which is, you know, kind of equal to the height of the image, so maybe 220 pixels. All right, so that is looking really good. We've got a crazy dance party going on now. Now, if you pause the talk through and try scrolling the page, you'll see that everything scrolls together. And the important thing is that absolute positioning is relative to the top of the web page. So as you scroll down the web page, things that were 10 pixels from the top are going to be moving off screen because you're going farther away from the top of the web page. Another option is fixed positioning, which will actually make it seem like things don't move at all. And if you want to try that out, we can just change H1 from absolute to fixed. And now pause and try scrolling. And you'll see that dance party just stays in the same place because now it's actually relative to the top of the screen, the window. Okay, so we've managed to use three different position properties to do some pretty cool stuff. When would we actually use absolute or fixed positioning? Well, you can use them to make a game, like I did here, because you'll want to lay out all the parts of the scene in the browser. But you can also use them for normal web pages. Like on Khan Academy, we use absolute positioning for the modals that we pop up in the middle of the page and use fixed positioning for the search box on our team page so that it's always visible as you scroll. You probably won't use position in every web page, but when you do use it, you'll be really happy it exists.